Hi friends, we are back with our next video, and this time it is the Game of Thrones tour to Winterfell which we took from Dublin. The details of the tour are shared in the description below. So if you are a GOT fan, don't miss this and please do watch it till the end, because you will be able to hear some of the fantastic behind the scene experiences from a man who is part of this epic drama. Yes, this is Eric, the Wildling, our tour guide. Thank you so much, Eric, for making this trek a memorable one. So, without wasting further time, let's ride to the north.
So, if you get this question exactly correct, I will give you the script to season 6, episode 9. No pressure.
Just to show you guys how much pressure is on everybody, working on the biggest show in the world, there's a camera in your face now, and 55 million people are going to watch the very first episode of season 8. So you don't want to mess that up. You'll be on DVD forever, alright? So if you go back and watch Hard Home, the scene where the whites are crawling over the palisade gate and they attack Hard Home, that was a one shot take. They only had one shot at this palisade gate. As soon as it falls, it's going to fall to pieces, and it would take way too much to try and get it back together. So with one shot, that's all they had. And you go back and watch it, it fell on a stuntman's leg and broke his leg. But instead of calling for the medic or for help or to stop the take, he ran on a broken leg because he didn't want to ruin the only shot they had. That's the kind of hard-working people that are making the best show in the world, is we don't care about dying and stuff for TV. That's on record. So, back to the scene. Will rides through the haunted forest. He sees a campfire in the distance. He gets off his horse. He begins to crawl. And the camera cuts and he's right here where you guys stand. Scared for his life. And as he's running away, he sees a dead wildling girl attached to a tree. And she's attached to this tree right here. She was real. She was a real girl. Wasn't a prop. She was 19 years old. And you guys can see when you get close enough, the drill holes in the tree are still here. The actual iron is in the tree. But for us, the viewer at home, the camera pans to this. That's an overview of all the dead, decapitated wildling bodies. In this kind of symbol or pattern or completely random or something else. I don't know. Where do I? Find out in 2 months. Like this. Guys, kind of scale of how much they've changed people's minds about stuff. Jamie and Cersei, who are together, who are brother and sister, and everyone's like, oh my god, that's incest, this is so gross. Whoa. Season 7, episode 7 ends in incest. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, get your auntie pregnant. Yeah.
Sean Bean, Ned Stark. If you guys didn't know, he's the reason they all have North English accents in the show. On audition, he was asking, do you do any other accents? He said, no. So they changed every single person's accent to match his, so they could continue on with the show. Okay, so they get off their horses, they find the dead stag, they then make their way down the...
What is it? Mountain lion?
And on this rocky slab in front of you guys is where they lay the dead direwolf mother, is where they find the direwolf pups. You guys can see from this screenshot here, a nice little reference. I will leave the screenshot down for you guys to take a better picture as I'm going to move through the crowd now, but you can see the direwolf pup was left on that rock directly across the river, okay?
So we're now in Frey country. I'm going to take you guys to the campsite where Rob captures Jamie Lannister. Top of this road. When you get to the top of the road, there will be a plaque, and that is the third plaque of the day where you can see the Battle of the Ox Cross.
Directly in front of you guys,
the 15th century castle owned by the Audley family. And for you guys, it was used as an outpost to Rob's camp where they capture Jamie Lannister. So just over the horizon is where you can see these two characters here, which is Catelyn and Sir Roderick riding on the horizon of Rob's camp.
Itself cut to the back of their heads, which shows Rob's camp where they've captured Jamie Lannister. Everything in this screenshot, what's going to happen over the next other locations is going to be a lot of computer graphics used, but there's no computer graphics used in this shot, okay? All the snow is real for this scene, all the tents are built up for this scene, and it's all real because most of the events of the show are taken from real life history. So for example, the Red Wedding, that big gruesome thing, is based off Scottish history called the Black Dinner, which the same sort of style thing happened in Scotland, what happened to the Starks. The Shape of Westeros, if you guys get a chance and you have the right software, if you take Ireland and put it underneath the UK, and then image flip the UK, that is the Shape of Westeros. The Wall. Around this way, Audley's Castle, as I mentioned, is an outpost for Rob's camp when they capture Jamie Lannister, but it is also Walder Frey's twins. So what they did is they take every brick of Audley's Castle and they stretched it three times its own size, and then took this tower, duplicated it, and brought it down here. You guys can see the area of Strangford, the forestry, the big tall tree that I mentioned to look out for is just directly in front of you guys. So they just took this castle and just dropped it in front of you guys. Part of the scene starts as they come out of the shore at the Trident. They begin to walk this way. The camera then cuts and it's right where the last few people are there. As they begin to continue this way, they come to exactly where you're standing, and then above your heads is what they see.
So the tree just above me is the hanging tree, where Jamie and Brienne find the three Stark hanging women, and then they get interrupted by three Stark soldiers, where Brienne shows her, you know, why she's the biggest fighting badass in the whole show. All right.
Ah, they lay with lions. Tavern girls, I'd say.
But what they'll do is they'll try and make everything as real as possible. So for the people who have watched Battle of the Bastards, you guys remember the crush sequence that happens when the Boltons come in with their shields and they keep coming in? The best way to make it look like 500 people are being crushed to death, who've never done acting classes in their life, just have beards, is to actually crush us for real. So they trained the Boltons, they came in, the guys from the SAS came in to train the Bolton soldiers, pretty much full metal jacket, shouted at these guys for 3 weeks straight, until the only job was to hold that shield and that 15-foot pike for the whole time. They were a regimental army, and I thought they had to have everything set up. So we're now in the crush. It's like 12 inches of water and mud and so on, and now this is happening. There's a guy coming in with a shield, and he's trying to do that. And obviously, what are you going to do? You're not going to stand there and get hit with a shield. You're going to start backing up. You're going to start creating space. And then Miguel Sapochnik, who directed that episode, said, if you're hit with a sword or a spear, you've been hit with a sword or a spear. You have to die. You have to go on the ground. We're going to shoot the, you know, CGI blood in afterwards. So now there's a kind of stake involved. If you get hit, you have to lie on the ground. The ground is now water and mud and horse piss and everything. No one wanted to lie down in it. So what's happening is now, if this is happening and you're going back, I'm now taking smaller extras and just throwing them in front of me, trying to make space and survive, you know? And they created that chaos, and they had stunt performers with dog collar style kind of blood packs around their throats with a layer of prosthetic skin over it. So it just looks like a normal neck. But if someone swings an axe at you and you turn towards you, who hasn't been told, there's a blood explodes in your face, you've now been like, and that shock has now been caught on camera. That real life, holy shit, has been caught on camera. There was amputees on set, guys with missing arms and missing legs. The guys with missing arms were given prosthetic arms. So if I come over and cut your arm, it's just gonna drop off and start pissing blood everywhere. And we've not been told this. And we've only slept 3 hours the night before. We've not eaten in, you know, 6 or 7 hours. So hangry, like when people are on fire, the stunt performers, they're screaming like they're on fire. So it's that kind of balance of, is he all right? And so like, we were shooting a scene for one of the shows that I was doing, and as we were running away, one of the main actors fell and started screaming. And human nature, I stopped him and, all right. And he went, it's an arrow, you fucking idiot. And I went, yup. And I just ruined that shot because he got shot with a fake arrow and stuff. And so all that sort of thing of like, we had a safe word at Battle of the Bastards during the crush. If you're genuinely suffocating, the word is banana. I think Minions had just come out, and we were shooting the crush, and people are climbing over the body pile, which was real. It was like three big massive steps with 1,000 corpses on it. The top layer of the corpses is people with missing legs and guts and all hanging out of them. And there's chaos, it's carnage, it's like Black Friday, but in costume. And you could just hear, but I'm not stopping the show. I'm not being the guy going, there's a man dying. I'm continuing on my life. I'm a wildling, you know? And all you hear is, what the fuck, man? I was shouting the code word of the banana. And he's like, I just thought you were saying Brian. He's shouting that. So yeah, no one's ever died. That's, yeah, no one's ever died. This location that we're at is the courtyard of Winterfell. This is Winterfell. This is the original set of Winterfell. The scene that you guys are going to see on the bus on the way home is Arya as she watches King Robert's arrival. So just behind you guys over here is where they had the cart placed. As she climbs on the cart, she's looking at Robert's procession come down this pathway here, past all the buildings, past that building labeled the Potter's Cottage, and under the archway to meet with all the Starks. That here, okay, so this is what we would film on an average day, and then when it cuts to the actual episode, when you guys watch it, using the magic of Microsoft Paint or whatever they use, this is what you like to show at home. It's like 9 months of post production. All the stuff up the line.
you'll see it on the way home, but the one I'm just explaining is King Robert's arrival. Just before the scene where Arya climbs onto the cart, it shows Bran and he's climbing up the sides of Winterfell. Obviously being 10 years old, it's incredibly dangerous for a 10-year-old to be up something that high. So what they had to do for those sequences, like the scene where he's come down off the wall, or when in the final scene of episode one where he catches Jaime and Cersei together, that was done using camera cuts, green screen, and a rock wall. And basically just above this blue van here is where they placed this little rock frame for him, this little rock wall for him, okay? So using harnesses and green screen, attached to the two buildings over there, they made this little area for him. And Isaac, who plays Bran, would climb up the first three steps.
So back to the actual arrival of King Robert. He comes down from the climbing frame and he meets with all of the Starks. They're pretty much in line with the benches that are here. So pretty much across this area here is where you see the backs of the Starks' heads. And directly behind you guys is the Ward Tower. And I'll just show you guys. So you can see all of the heads of the Starks. Foreshadowing is a massive thing in Game of Thrones. What they'll do is they'll have repeated scenes, repeated dialogue, and just little nods to stuff that if you're not really paying attention, goes completely over your head. And this thing is one of the most famous things is King Robert's curse. And you guys going back, watch episode one, every Stark that King Robert has touched, how he gets off his horse, has actually died in the show. And Arya asks Arya what her name is. Same way Jack and the guards been asking what her name is for the last three seasons, right? Loads of things to look out for when John mentions his family. Every time before he mentions his family, there's a Targaryen reference. And then after a Jon Snow scene, there's always a Targaryen scene. Like it. Here you go, episode one.